My nuclear button is bigger than yours. Yes, that was a taunt heard round the world. President Donald Trump taking to Twitter to measure his button to that of volatile leader Kim Jong-un. An absolutely stunning scenario given the stakes. Nuclear war. The schoolyard taunt happening at the same time the Trump administration was basking in an incredible step toward diplomacy. Reports of possible dialogue between the North and the South confirmed just hours after the tweet. North Korea picking up the phone not once but twice to reopen a hotline to South Korea. But was it undermined by Trump's taunt? It's hard to say. But oh, to have been a fly on the wall at the president's lunch today with Secretary of State Rex Tillerson and Defense Secretary Jim Mattis. With me now, Garrett Graff, CNN contributor, historian, and author of Raven Rock, the story of the U.S. government's secret plan to save itself while the rest of us die. I always laugh when I read your title. A book that looks at the U.S. government's doomsday plans in a nuclear world. So nice to see you. Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you.
On all of this, let's get past the BS and the playground, you know, chatter, and on to what actually happens. I mean, if heaven forbid, walk us through the actions of a sort of a nuclear war.
Sure. So we often forget that all of the things that we sort of think of as the majestic toys of the presidency, Marine One, Air Force One, the armored motorcades, are really tools to ensure that the President of the United States can launch nuclear weapons wherever he is, anywhere on the surface of the planet, in a moment's notice. That wherever he is, that military aide carrying that nuclear football is just a few steps behind him. You know, when he's on the golf course, that football is in one of the golf carts following him. You know, if he gets on an elevator, that nuclear football gets on that elevator with him. Mm-hmm. And that football, the black briefcase, contains everything that he needs to launch nuclear war. Contrary to his tweet, there really isn't any such thing as a nuclear button.
Yeah, spoiler alert, there is no button.
He has a big red button on his desk in the Oval Office.
Let's show the picture. Let me stop you and show the picture, because Pete Souza, who used to be the presidential photographer for President Obama, shows the button. This is the red button in the Oval Office. Has nothing to do with the nuclear order. So please continue.
And
I just want to show it.
What it does is it summons the White House steward with a Coca-Cola. What the president would do in launching a nuclear weapon is he would turn to that military aide, who would bring forth the briefcase, and it's basically a telephone and a series of binders with pre-printed nuclear options in it. One military aide who used to be responsible for it has compared it to the Denny's menu of nuclear war.
What is that supposed to mean? We've all been to Denny's, but...
It's a bunch of pictures with what type of nuclear war you'd like to order. And this was an effort actually by President Jimmy Carter to boil down what would be a complicated, horrific Armageddon scenario under pressure, knowing that the president wouldn't have time to think a lot and instead would just point at a couple of different pictures that he would want to order nuclear war.
No kidding. And this whole my button is bigger than yours, how does this rhetoric compare to president's past?
Brooke, it is, I think, probably the most reckless statement we have ever seen a president of the United States make about nuclear weapons. Yeah. To say that it is out of historical character is an understatement. Presidents throughout history, going back to Harry Truman, the first president to confront this power, normally go out of their way to not be reckless in their words about nuclear weapons. I mean, this is the ultimate authority that presidents have. There is no second voice in this system. Presidents just order the launch of nuclear weapons, and they take that in the past very seriously and very soberly.
As they should.
And every president that we have seen speak publicly about nuclear weapons in the past talks about this with the utmost respect. And I think that it is almost impossible from a historical perspective to capture just how out of character the president's tweet was last night.
Should be held to the utmost respect. You are absolutely right, Garrett Graff. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
It's nice to see